What's up? Welcome back. So, I'm going to get right into it because I want to continue discussing what I was talking about last time. Last time, I had mentioned I was talking about some good starting points if you wanted to get into Star Wars books. And I will probably make this its own video.
Lord Vader has tracked the stolen Imperial plans to Ambassador Organa.
Here we go. This should be fun. This is obviously the opening of A New Hope right now. I was talking about some good starting points, and I mentioned the Dark Lord trilogy and also the original Thrawn trilogy. Both good starting points if you want to see, you know, what Star Wars Expanded Universe is all about, what Legends is all about, you know. Just some good content in general. But if you're more interested in new canon, I think it really just depends on if you really like Rebels. If you do, highly recommend The New Dawn, which is all about Kanan and Hera meeting up for the first time. A New Dawn is phenomenal. It's a great story. It's by itself, so you don't have to commit to a series or anything. It's just kind of a prelude to Rebels itself. And if you were interested in getting into the new canon and you liked Rebels, check out A New Dawn. If you didn't like Rebels and you're interested in checking out the new canon, well, I would say maybe the new Thrawn trilogy. Because even though it does work around Thrawn as a character from Rebels, the first book, at least, is all before his time on the screen in Rebels. Hell yeah, I'll play as Vader.
Head to the tech room.
And even though the second book, Thrawn Alliances, is between seasons 3 and 4 of Rebels. Am I going in here? Yeah. Love this. And then the third one, which is Treason, Thrawn Treason, takes place in the middle of Season 4. There's a period of Season 4 where Thrawn leaves Lothal for a little bit, and it's basically Thrawn's time during that. The new Thrawn trilogy is one that some people have looked on kind of negatively because of the way it portrays Thrawn, which I understand. It also is just great, in my opinion. Like, I get some of the complaints with it, but at the end of the day, I have loved Thrawn, Thrawn Alliances, which is basically a Thrawn and Vader team-up book that spends half its time being a Thrawn and Anakin Skywalker team-up book as well. And then Thrawn Treason, which is just some fascinating stuff, adds a whole lot of lore to the Chiss. Which, of course, leads us also into Thrawn Ascendancy.
We need the ship access codes to gain entry to the escape pod areas. Make your way to the engine room.
Which is another... If you don't even want to read the Thrawn trilogy, you can go right to the Thrawn Ascendancy trilogy if you want. And one of the great things about the Ascendancy trilogy is that it is not connected. Let's go through here. Where is it? I can't tell where it wants me to go.
Disable the turbine to clear our way to the terminal.
Okay, gotta go around. One of the great things about the Thrawn Ascendancy trilogy is that it is not connected. How do I get up there? Am I crazy? Oh, I could double jump. Cool. It's not really connected to anything. It has to have Thrawn leave at the end of the trilogy, and that's it. Alright, you don't have to worry about any other story elements. It does tie into Alliances a little bit. But for the most part, it stands by itself, and it's awesome for that. and it works so well. It's just so, it's genuinely great content. It's Zahn entirely just building on the lore of the Chiss.
Defeat is not acceptable. Fight harder. Our reserves are running dangerously low.
All right, yeah. Well, if I could figure out where to go, here we go.
Nice work. Now let's clear those rebels out of the escape pod bays and secure the rest of the ship. Princess Leia must be captured before she can escape.
But where am I supposed to go? So where's Leia? Like, I'm losing my guys here. I don't know where Leia is. I guess she's gotta be in here somewhere. There she is. Got her.
The day is ours.
One! Whew, thank goodness. I was getting worried at the end there. Just recommend all those. And of course, I also recognize the High... Recommend the High Republic. Read Light of the Jedi, The Rising Storm, and The Fallen Star. It's all you gotta read. You can read the other stuff, of course, too. If you're not interested in that, you can read the non-adult books. Focus a little bit more on the characters than the story. It's fine, too. Oh, this is going to be a hard mission. I might fail this, too. Let's see.
Transports are trying to go around us. Destroy them before they can jump to hyperspace.
Recon bomber behind you.
So I gotta destroy these four fucking giant ass transports in 3 minutes. Luckily, one bombing run almost does that. I'll turn around. Got one. Some other books I hadn't mentioned yet. If you're interested in the some more of the new canon post Return of the Jedi, I've heard a lot of really good things about Alphabet Squadron. Another trilogy of books. I'm not sure where exactly it falls between the original trilogy and the sequel trilogy. Because I haven't really read it. I was interested in it for a little bit, but I don't really care. Of course, the X-Wing series in Legends is another popular one, as I'm just kind of going over books now. Again, one that I didn't really enjoy. I've tried to. It doesn't really interest me that much. Let's see what else. Some more new canon. Dark Disciple, if you're interested in Asajj Ventress a little bit.
Harassing our fighters. Show them no mercy.
Oh, boy. Wait, what? Oh, they were invisible. I could have sworn that ship's healed in this, but I guess not. Got one. Making my way over to the other one. Ah, I couldn't get it before I died. It's fine. Let's see what else we got. Yeah, so Dark Disciple about Asajj Ventress and the Night Sisters. It's decent. It's not. I don't like it. But I can see the appeal in it if someone did want to, or was interested in that. So, you know, if you want, check it out. It's worth a check out if the idea interests you a little bit.
Pilots, if they are allowed to make the jump to hyperspace, they'll rip right through us. Clear their fighters out and be quick about it. we haven't any time to spare.
Alright. I've got to move very fast here. This is a really hard part of the mission.
Attention, all second stage pilots on deck.
No interceptors? No interceptor. All right. Oh, I gotta kill 10 fighters. I didn't know there was a guy right behind me. I should have stayed on him. Damn it. I like the incoming missile warning when I was already fucking dead. Oh, an interceptor. Sweet. I was wondering when that was going
to
spawn. Got him. The reason I'm trying to rush this, even though 10 minutes feels like a lot of time, is because once I destroy the fighters, I am going to have to also use my bomb on a bunch of parts of a bigger ship. Got him. I thought I got him. I guess not. Come on. I don't have much time. I gotta move quickly. I'm like pressing right click and there's no missiles there. You can't shake me that easily, rebel scum. Get over here. Dodge that missile. Look at him maneuver. No maneuvering to do when you're dead. Ooh, the sun glare blinded me for a second. Got it.
Well done, pilots. We need to clear a path for our frigates to cover you. Use a TIE bomber to destroy their heavy turrets.
It's just faster to kill myself at this point. Of course, I spawned so far back, disproving my point. Shouldn't there be a bomber right there? Make me run all the way over here. Just to, all right, whatever.
Hostile behind you.
All right, here we go. 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 This is the hardest space mission in the game, without question. Here we go, here we go, here we go. Got one. Alright, because this isn't even it. I gotta do some more shit after this part. Got that one. Okay, nope, I'm low, too. I can only really afford one death if I want to have time. Got it. All right, one more.
Fire on that bomber.
Ah, it's unlucky. Just one bomb. I hate when that happens. Oh boy, he's gonna be shooting at me in a second here. Ooh, tonight. They can't jump if they haven't got any engines. Well, isn't that astute observation right there? Let's get around the back here. Oh my god, I hate it. I hate it. I hate it. I hate when I go to bomb and only one bomb comes. Oh no! Fuck. This is a bad thing. It's gonna take me like half a minute to get over there. I have to go into the underbelly to get there in time. It's gonna wait. I'm gonna waste time. I'm wasting time. No. I don't want to replay this fucking bullshit level. Sometimes games make levels that are just like insanely hard, and people are like, "This game's so good." No. I mean, I'm not saying this game is bad because I do like this game a lot. But a game like Dark Souls. Everyone says, you know, people are like, Dark Souls is so good, and, you know, it's too hard, like, get good. Like, no, fuck you. Just because something's impossibly difficult. Oh, Jesus Christmas. It doesn't make it fun. Alright, here we go. One engine. Can I get five more of those? Dude, it takes forever for these engines to, for these bombs to refresh. I guess not. So why does only one bomb come out sometimes? Where are these missiles coming from? Hello? Did you guys see that? The health didn't go down at all. Oh, fuck me.
You picked up a bomber.
Got that one. Oh, boy.
Chase down that fire.
Another one. Okay, as long as I don't die, I should be able to get this, but I keep losing health. Let's try this again. Bro, this is nonsense! Oh, no, 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 no! I'm just dying! I'm just dying! I don't even see what's shooting at me! I should have won. I should have won by now.
Target that spider and take him down.
What? The one bomb curse! No! This isn't fair! This isn't fair! There's no way! There's no way this is happening. The one bomb curse struck at the worst time. I still don't know why that does that. I thought it was timing, but... Come on. And also, twice I targeted the engines, the bombs hit and just didn't do any damage. I'm racing the clock here, racing the clock! Oh!
Victory is ours, men. Dispatch the five hundred and first to the planet's surface. Yavin 4 will fall before the day is done.
Bro, I was sweating. I was not sure that I was gonna come out on top. Oh my god. Okay. That's another two missions out of the way now, huh? We got one more batch, I think, in us. So, we'll see you next time.